Okay, dear students, today in this class you are going to learn about some of the measures of the exterior angle of a polygon. Okay, look at this figure. See, here on many occasions knowledge of exterior angles may throw light on the nature of interior angles and sides, right? So here they have given figure. See, draw a polygon on the floor using piece of a chalk. Okay, see, in the figure it is a pentagon, that is A, B, C, D, E, right, as shown in the figure. We want to know that a total measure of all the angles, that is measuring angle of 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5, right? We have to start from A. See, A walk along B, okay, A walk along AB, right? On reaching B, you need to turn through an angle of M1, right? See, to an angle of 1. See, to walk along BC, when you reach at C, you need to turn through an angle of M, angle 2, right? Angle 2, walk along CD, right? See, you continue to move this manner until you turn to side, that is AB, right? You have to turn. So you would have in fact made one complete turn, which is equal to, that is 360 degree. Therefore, the measuring angle of the external angles of any polygon is 360 degree, right? Okay, dear students, now let us discuss about exercise 4.2, right? See, here we have first main, find x in the following figures. Here we have first figure, right? That is 125 degree exterior angle. Here also 125 degree exterior angle. We need to find out, that is x degree. That is also exterior angle. Okay, dear students, now let us discuss about first main, okay? Here they have given figure here. See, we need to find out first these two interior angles, right? I will take it as P and I will take it as Q, right? See here, 125 degree plus Q, which is equal to 180 degree. 125 degree plus P is equal to 180 degree because of linear pair. Because of linear pair angles. Okay, see here, P is equal to 180 minus 125. Okay, and P is equal to 180 minus 25, which is equal to 55, right? Which is equal to 55 degree. Why should we need to find out this P and Q? Means because the exterior angle property, okay? Exterior angle property, which is equal to the interior opposite angles. The sum of two interior opposite angles, okay? P is equal to 55 degree we got. Now we need to find out Q. Here Q plus 125 degree, which is equal to 180 degree. This is also linear pair. Q plus 125 degree, which is equal to 180 degree. Q is equal to 180 minus 125 degree. Therefore, Q is equal to also 55 degree. Okay. 55 degree. Now we need to find out, that is x. Okay, x is equal to, we have to put here question mark. Okay, we need to find out now x. See here, x is equal to, x degree is equal to, that is the sum of two interior opposite angles, that is P plus Q, right? That is P is equal to 55 degree plus Q is equal to also 55 degree. Therefore, x is equal to 110 degree is right answer. Okay, dear students, now let us discuss about in this B question, right? Here they have given figure. Here also we need to find out value of x. Okay, see here, we know that the sum of the measures of the external angles of any polygon is 360 degree, right? The measure of, I will write this here, the sum of measure of the external angles of any polygon is 360 degree. Therefore, they have given here perpendicular. Therefore, it means what is this angle? 90 degree, right? Here they have given 60 degree. Okay, here also perpendicular has given here 90 degrees. Therefore, this is also 90 degree exterior angle, right? So here also exterior angle is x, we need to find. Okay, here also given exterior angle, that is 70 degree. Okay, therefore the sum of measures of the exterior external angles of any polygon is 360 degree. Okay, sum, we have to add all those. Okay, here x plus 90 plus 60 plus 90 plus 70, which is equal to 360 degree. Therefore x plus 90 plus 90 180, 60 plus 70 130. Therefore we will get here 310 degree is equal to 360 degree. X is equal to 360 degree minus 300 degree transport to RHS, it will be minus 310. Okay, therefore x is equal to 360 minus 310, which is equal to, that is 50 degree. Therefore the exterior angle of value of x is 50 degree. Okay dear students, you can do like this also by taking as angles linear base. By taking a linear base also you can do it. Okay, because we know that sum of angles of a pentagon, which is equal to 540 degree, right? Because of number of sides is equal to 5. Okay, number of sides is equal to 5. Therefore we have to take this formula, that is n minus 1 into 180. Okay, number of sides is 5. 5 minus 1 into 180, right? Okay, and this also we will get same values. This is not n minus 1, this is n minus 2 it is. Okay, n minus 2 into 180. Here 5 minus 2 is equal to 3. Therefore 18. Okay, 18 3 ja 54. 540 degree we will get, right? See, even after adding all those exterior angles and which is equal to, this is a 900 degree we will get, right? Okay, by taking as x plus all those 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 angles plus 310, because we will get a linear pair which is equal to 180 degree, right? See, 180 total, how many are there? 5 are there. 18 into 5, which is equal to, see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 means 18 into 180 degree, 18 into 5, that is we will get 18 5 is 990, is nothing but 900. 900 we will get. After subtracting, we will get the same values, okay? We will get the same values, that is 50 degree only we will get, right? Okay, you can try at home. And this is very easy method. Okay, we know that already the sum of measure of the external angles of any polygon is 360 degree. Okay dear students, now let us discuss about second main. Find the measure of each exterior angle of a regular polygon of 9 sides and 15 sides. First question and second question we need to find. Okay, here we have first question, that is they are given number of sides, that is how many sides? 9 sides. Okay, first one, see, sum of angles of a regular polygon, sum of angles of a regular polygon is n minus 2 into 180 degree, right? See, number of sides is equal to n is equal to 9, right? N is equal to 9, 9 minus 2 into 180 degree, right? See, 9 minus 2 which is equal to 7, 7 into 18. See here, 7 into 180. Therefore, 18, 7 is how much here? 126. Therefore, 1260. Okay, 1260 we got, right? Therefore, now interior angle. Interior angle, each interior angle we need to find out first, okay? Because we know that interior angle plus exterior angle, which is equal to 180 degree, right? Okay, see, if you find this angle, angle of interior, okay, then we need to find out exterior angle, because they asked a question here, find the measure of each exterior angle, right? Exterior angle of a regular polygon. Here interior angle, how will you find? Each interior angle is equal to sum of interior angles divided by number of sides. Okay, keep that formula. Okay, each interior angle, each interior angle is equal to sum of interior angles, sum of interior angles divided by number of sides. Okay, see, sum of interior angles is equal to how much we got here? That is only sum of angles of a regular polygon. That is how much we got here? 1260 degree divided by number of sides. How much they have given? 9 he has given, right? So we have to divide it. 9 1 ja 9 and remaining 36. 9 4 ja 36 0. Therefore we got here 140 degree. Now very easy to find interior angle plus exterior angle, which is equal to 180 degree, right? Okay, see, for example, like this is, that means this is interior angle and this is exterior angle, right? Simple. Okay, both are having linear pairs. I will write here linear pair of angles. So interior angle is equal to how much we got here? 140 degree plus exterior angle is equal to 180 degree. Therefore exterior angle is equal to 180 minus 140 degree. Therefore exterior angle is equal to 180 minus 140, which is equal to, that is 40 degree, and this is right answer. Okay, now let us discuss about second question. Here we have 15 sides, right? See, here number of sides is equal to 15. So sum of angles of a regular polygon is n minus 2 into 180 degree. Therefore number of sides is 15. 15 minus 2 into 180 degree, okay, is equal to 15 minus 2 is 13. 13 into 180. Therefore 18 into 13, how much we will get here? How much we will get here? 24. Okay, see here. 18 3 ja 54. 5 18 3 ja 54. 18 1 ja 18. 19 20 23. 2 3 4 0. Right? 2 3 4 0. Okay. 2 3 4 0 we will get. So now each interior angle is equal to sum of interior angles divided by number of sides is equal to 2 3 4 0 divided by, we will get here 15, right? Okay, 15 1 ja 15. Here also 15 1 ja 15, right? Okay, 15 1 ja 15, 15 1 ja 15, and remaining is 8. Okay, remaining is 8. Therefore 15 5 ja 75 and remaining is 90. Therefore 15 6 ja 90. Therefore we get here 156 degree. That is interior angle. Now we need to find out exterior angle. We know that exterior angle plus interior angle plus exterior angle is equal to 180 degree because of linear pair. Interior angle is 156 degree plus exterior angle is equal to 180. Exterior angle is equal to 180 minus 156 degree. Therefore exterior angle is equal to 180 minus 156, which is equal to, we get here 24 degree. This is right answer. Okay, see, you can do easy method also. How means? Each exterior angle property is equal to sum of all exterior angles divided by number of sides. That also you will get the same answer, right? Okay, here we have third question. See here, how many sides? We need to find out number of sides. Okay, does a regular polygon have? If the measure of exterior angle is 24 degree, we need to find out number of sides. Okay, now let us discuss about, that is the third main solution. Okay, third question solution. See, number of sides. We need to find number of sides is equal to, put here question mark. And also given here sum of exterior angles. Okay, sorry. He has given here the measure of an exterior angle is, the measure of an exterior angle is 24 degree, given. Okay, given it is. Therefore, we know that sum of exterior angles, sum of exterior angles of a regular polygon is 360 degrees. Therefore, formula that is each exterior angle is equal to sum of exterior angles divided by number of sides, right? See, this formula only you can do cross multiplication, right? Okay, exterior angle is equal to sum of exterior angles, that is 360 degrees, divided by number of sides we need to find n. Okay, by cross multiply, see, exterior angle, sum of exterior angle, that is 360 degrees, given. Okay, we know that. Okay, next, divided by number of sides, we need to find out number of sides. Exterior angle is equal to how much as given here? Exterior angle is equal to 24 degrees as given, right? Therefore, here I will write 24 degrees is equal to 360 degrees divided by n. Now by cross multiply, n is equal to 360 degrees divided by, take this 24 below. Okay, now you do cancel and write the solution. Okay, let us see now. 6 4 ja 24, 6 6 ja 36, okay, is equal to 60 degrees divided by 4. 4 1 ja 4, here also 4 1 ja 4, and 4 5 ja 20. Therefore, number of sides is equal to 15. Number of sides is equal to 15, right? This is right answer. Okay, dear students, now let us discuss about fourth question. How many sides does a regular polygon have if each of its interior angle is 165 degrees? Okay, this is also very easy. Okay, now let us discuss about fourth question. Okay, solution we have. See here, number of sides we need to find. Number of sides is equal to put question mark. Okay, and also given here the measure of interior angle. The measure of interior angle is equal to, that is 165 degrees, given. Okay, given, right? We know that interior angle plus exterior angle is equal to 180 degrees, because of, that is a linear pair. Okay, see, interior angle is equal to, as given, 165 degrees plus exterior angle is equal to 180. Exterior angle is equal to 180 minus 165 degrees. Therefore, exterior angle is equal to 180 minus 165, which is equal to, that is 15 degrees, right? Exterior angle is equal to 15 degrees. Now we need to find out here number of sides. Therefore, number of sides. Okay, see, I will write direct now. Number of sides is equal to sum of exterior angles divided by each exterior angle, right, is equal to sum of exterior angle, which is equal to, we know that is 360 degrees. Okay, sum of all exterior angles is equal to 360 degrees. We know this. Okay, 360 divided by each interior angle, how much we got here? 15 divided by 15. 15 1 ja 15, 15 2 ja 30, and 15 4 ja 60. Therefore, number of sides is equal to 24 is right answer. N is equal to 24 is right answer, number of sides. Okay, now let us discuss about fifth question. A, is it possible have a regular polygon with measure of each exterior angle is as 22 degrees? See, it is not possible, because exterior angle, sum of exterior angle divided by 22, it is not possible. Therefore, we will get a rational number, right? Therefore, it is not possible. Therefore, this answer is no. And B also they have asked question, can it be an interior angle of a regular polygon and why they asked? See, this answer is also no, it is also not possible. Because if you done 180 minus 22, we will get here 158. But 158 which is not a divisor of 360 degree, right? Okay, I will write solution now. One here 22 also, 22 degree also is not a divisor of 360 degree. Okay, this answer is, it is not possible. It is not possible. Okay, therefore answer is no. Okay, it is not possible to have a regular polygon. Okay, to have a regular, no, okay, this no need to write. Okay, it is not possible, just you write this no, because 22 is not a divisor, is not a divisor of 360 degree, right? Okay, next B answer also, what I told answer, that is also no, because of each exterior angle, see, because of exterior angle is equal to, we will do here 180 minus 22, right? We will get here 158. But 158, which is not a divisor, which is not a divisor of 360 degree. Okay, this is the right answer. Okay, now let us discuss about the sixth question. What is the minimum interior angle possible for a regular polygon and why they have asked you, right? See, for example, I will take here triangle, equilateral triangle, okay, equilateral triangle. See, here I will take each angle measure as S. Is total how many x are there? 3x is equal to 180, because we know that the sum of three angles of a sum of the interior angles of a triangle is 180 degree. Therefore, x is equal to 180 minus 180 divided by 3. That is, we will get each angle is 60 degree, right? Each angle we will get here 60 degree. Therefore, the equilateral triangle being a regular polygon of how many sides are there? Of three sides. Okay, as the least measure of an interior angle, that is 60 degree. Okay, see, now second question. Second question, what will be there here? B, what is the maximum exterior angle possible for a regular polygon? See, by a question, this only what I will do, okay, I will extend this one, okay, this is exterior angle, okay, simply here, interior angle plus exterior angle, which is equal to 180 degree, therefore, we will get here in exterior angle, we know that interior angle is 60 degree, okay, so exterior angle is equal to 180 minus 60, which is equal to, we get here 120 degree. We can observe that, see, we can observe that the greatest exterior angle is 120 degree. This is the right answer. Okay, I will write solution now. Okay, I will write solution, that is question number 6, that is A. Okay, the equilateral triangle of a regular polygon, okay, being a regular polygon, I will write, okay, being a regular polygon of how many sides? Three sides. As the least measure of an interior angle of 60 degree. We know that the sum of all angles, right? Sum of all the angles, all the interior angles of a triangle is 180 degree. Therefore, I will take here, I have taken here x, 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 now each angle measures. Therefore, x plus x is equal to 180. Therefore, 3x is equal to 180. Therefore, x is equal to 31 ja 3, 360 ja. X is equal to 60 degree. Okay, same. And B question also. By A question, okay, by A question, we can observe that exterior angle plus interior angle is equal to 180 degree, okay, because of a linear pair, right? Here interior we got already 60 degree, therefore exterior angle is, how much we will get? Exterior angle is equal to 180 minus 60. Therefore, exterior angle is equal to, we get here 120 degree. Therefore, we can observe that the greatest exterior angle is 120 degree. Okay, and this is right answer. Dear students, now let us discuss about kinds of quadrilaterals. See, kinds of quadrilaterals is based on the nature of sides, angles of a quadrilaterals, and it gets special names also. Trapezium is a quadrilateral with a pair of parallel sides. What are those? See here, the arrow marks indicates the parallel sides, right? Okay, see, this arrow mark and this arrow mark having the parallel side. Here also given parallel sides. See, these two are non-parallel. The arrow mark which not indicates, those are not parallel lines, right? Okay, for example, this and this also not parallel. Okay, non-parallel. Okay, here also they have put here arrow mark, this is a parallel sides. Okay, and here put mark, this is also parallel sides having, and this line is also parallel because it is looking like a parallelogram, right? And see, these are trapeziums and these are not trapeziums. See, trapezium is a quadrilateral because quadrilateral having how many sides here? Four sides. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4 for all having figures, four sides only. See, these are not trapeziums. These are not trapezium. Okay, they are given such kind of quadrilaterals as well as polygon also, right? Okay, now see here, now let us discuss about kite. See here, kite is a special type of quadrilateral. For this also having how many sides here? Four sides, right? Okay, see, the sides with the same marking in each figure are equal. For example, AB is equal to AD, right? And BC is equal to CD. Okay, see here, these are kites. See, for adjacent sides having equal length, and here also having equal length for adjacent sides. Okay, adjacent sides. See here, and these are not kites. They have given here. Okay, study these figures and try to describe. Okay, let us see now. A kite has how many sides? Four sides. Therefore, it is a quadrilateral, right? And see, there are exactly two distinct consecutive pairs of sides of equal length. Okay, and check whether a square is a kite. Square is not a kite because squares having diagonals are equal, but in a kite diagonals are not equal, right? See, here what they told, there are exactly two different consecutive pairs, right? That is AB is equal to AD and BC is equal to CD. Okay. Okay. Now let us discuss about parallelogram. See, parallelogram is also a quadrilateral. Okay, as the name suggests, it has something to do with parallel lines, is it? See, one of its pair of its sides are parallel to each other. For example, AB is equal to DC. AB is parallel to DC and AD is parallel to BC. Here also PQ is parallel to RS and QS is also parallel to PR. LM is parallel to ON and LO is parallel to MN, right? See, these are parallelograms and these are not parallelograms. Here see, only AB is parallel to CD, is it? And these are non-parallel sides. And here also AB is parallel to, and here also what they are given, AB is also parallel to ED, and even here CD is also parallel to AF, even BC is also parallel to, BC is parallel to FE, right? Only, okay, these are not parallel sides. These are not parallelograms, okay. Okay, now let us discuss about elements of a parallelogram. See here, there are four sides and how many angles? Four angles, A, D, C and angle B, right? See here, A, D, A, B and B, C and C, D, those are sides, four sides. Okay, see, some of these are equal and there are some terms associated with these elements. Okay, that you need to remember the given. See, A, B, C, D, A, B, C, D is a parallelogram, right? Observe this figure. See here, AB and DC are opposite sides and even AD and BC form another pair of opposite sides. Okay, and angle A and angle C are opposite angles, another pair of opposite angles, that is angle D and angle B, right? Okay, and what are the adjacent sides? What are the adjacent sides are there here? See, AB and BC, these are adjacent sides like this. Okay, and even this means one of sides starts where the other. Okay, AB and BC are adjacent sides. This means one of the sides start where the other ends. See, BC and CD are BC and CD are adjacent sides too also. Okay, see, now adjacent angles, what are those? Angle A and angle B adjacent angles, angle B and angle C also adjacent angles, angle C and angle D also adjacent angles, angle D and angle E also adjacent angles. They are at the ends of the same sides of angle B and angle C are also adjacent, right? Okay, now let us discuss about diagonals of a parallelogram. See here, they have given here parallelogram figure. The diagonals of a parallelogram. See here, AC and BD are the diagonals of a parallelogram. But these diagonals are not of equal length, right? These are not of equal length. See here, even the diagonals here, they have given, see, the diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other at the point of their intersection, of course. Okay, meet at a point O, right? See here, we have to, they have given a triangle AOB and COD. These two triangles, see here, AB is parallel to CD, even AB is equal to CD. Okay, AB is parallel to CD. Okay, and also in triangle AOB, they have given one side of two angles. Therefore, this is angle side angle property or angle side angle axiom. Even therefore, AOB is congruent to triangle COD. Okay, see, therefore here, even here, what are the diagonals? AO is equal to OC and BO is equal to OD, right? Okay. In next class, we will discuss about exercise 4.3.